In this tutorial, we look how to combine paired reads to contigs. So if you have MySeq data, it's typically paired end, and we need to merge those pairs into contigs sequences. So after watching these videos, you will be able to describe how reads are joined by the Mothur package, what kind of things need to be taken into account, and what result files are produced. So Chipster uses the Mothur package for this step, as for many other steps in the microbial community analysis. And here it's the Mothur tool make contigs. So as an input file, it takes a tar package of fastq files. How to make that tar package was explained already in the quality control video. So what the make contigs tool does, it first creates a reverse complement of the reverse read, and then it performs a Needleman alignment for the two reads. So as you might remember, Needleman is a global sequence alignment method. So essentially we take our pair of reads and put them together so that we end up with one contig. Now, what happens if these two reads don't actually agree in this overlapping region? So there are rules for that. So if one of the reads has a base and the other one has a gap in that position, the quality of the base has to be at least 25 in order to be kept. If both reads have a base but the bases differ, then the quality difference has to be at least 6, and then the better base is kept. If the quality difference is less, then the base in that position is set to N in the contig. It's well known that Mothur has problems if the read overlap is short or if it's of bad sequence quality. So for example, the MySeq 300 chemistry produces low quality ends, and this is problematic for Mothur. The developer of Mothur, Patrick Slosh, has therefore recommended that one should sequence short regions, like roughly 250, in order to get full overlap. So we want to maximize the overlapping area from this to something like this. There is another tool package called VSEARCH, which has a tool, fastq merge pairs, which is meant to cope with this problematic ends better. And it also has a tool, fastq filter. Now, because of the licensing reasons, we are not able to, or we are not allowed to integrate VSEARCH in Chipster, unfortunately. So you get various result files, obviously the contigs themselves. They are now in FASTA format, and this file is compressed. In addition to the actual contigs, you get a lot of other information. So let's look at these files one by one. First of all, you get a file called samples-fastqstxt. Now this file allows you to check if Mothur did a good job when assigning the fastq files to samples. So basically you want to check here that, for example, so here I have a sample name and then the two files that were assigned to these samples. And I can see that yes, definitely this was the pair of fastq files. So the pairing was correct. So we had the R1 file for this sample and the R2 file for this sample. Now, if you would spot a mistake here, it is possible that you can make this file yourself. It's just a normal text file, and then you can give it as input to ensure that the pairing is done properly. Mothur also produces a groups file, because remember, now all your sequences from all the samples are in one FASTA file, but we still need to keep track of what sequence came from which sample. So this is the file that keeps track of that. So here we have a sequence name and then the sample that it comes from. You will also get a file called contig numbers, which just tells you how many contigs each of the samples had. And there is also the total number of sequences in all these samples. Finally, there is a summary file. Many of the analysis steps actually produce a summary file. So here, first of all, you will see the number of sequences. That's down here. After some later analysis steps, it will also list you the number of unique sequences or sort of non-identical sequences. And then you have a lot of stats, so the minimum, maximum, mean, median, and quantiles of various things. So number of bases, for example, so we can see that the shortest contig was 248 bases long, the longest was 502, which sort of rings a bell that something might be wrong there. We also get the number of ambiguous bases. So there was a read that had 248 ambiguous bases. Again, something we will want to remove later on. There's also the homopolymer length. So in this particular set, the longest homopolymer is 243 long. Again, something we probably want to remove. We also have start and end positions. So these are more meaningful when we look at the data after the alignment to the reference, because then we get the alignment positions here.